The science of Derby, the science of Derby, let's learn something new.
Hi, and welcome to the science of Derby with me, Professor Legs. Today we're going to be talking about stride. Number one, basic stance. And if you want a more in-depth scientific look at this, check out the video on stance. The Derby stance we all know and love is this nice, low, chest up, head up, knees bent forward, hips nice and low, low center of gravity, and I'm ready to go. Now that you've got your stance down, let's talk about the stride. And there's three main pieces of it. One is your wheels, one is which direction you're pushing, and one is using both your legs. Let's talk about the wheels first. Have a little trivia game here. So imagine these are three different skates with four wheels each, and we're gonna ask, where does the weight go on these four wheels as you're pushing through your stride? Number one, the inside wheels. A lot of people push through both their inside wheels as they're going. This is incorrect. Good guess, but incorrect. Second choice, kind of a toe flick. So the front inside wheel. Sorry to say, also wrong. The third option, what about all four wheels into the ground? This is the correct option. Why? Because this is how we get all of our force into the ground, all of our momentum. The more wheels we have on the ground, the more surface, the more power, the more speed, the more grip, the more friction, the more everything, the more better it is for roller derby. Now let's talk about how we're pushing through the floor. So which direction we're pushing with our legs. Now, if you take a look at your roller skate and we break it down to two simple things right now. One is the skate can kind of move back and forth like this. And the other is side to side. Looking at your roller skate from the top down and you're considering this front and back motion, the way the wheels like to roll, that lack of resistance, that lack of any friction, that prevents us from getting any force whatsoever. And you can try that out for yourself on your skates. Nothing happens. So it's totally useless. 0% of the power put into your skates in the front and back motion translate into an increase in speed. Conversely, that side to side motion, the wheels do not roll in that direction at all. So that means sideways force, when you're pushing sideways into the floor, 100% of the force goes into propelling your skates and body in a different direction. But let's break it down a little bit more scientifically so you can understand what this looks like in your stride. Because once you start adding the track and the choreography of the legs, things get a little more complicated. So let's look at a common case. A lot of beginner classes, coaches will tell new students to push through your leg 45 degrees to the back. So by pushing 45 degrees from my body to the back, I am adding some of that front and back motion we talked about and losing power. So to be precise, we're losing 29% of our power at a 45 degree angle. So only like 70% of our capacity to move forward using the energy that I'm already expending into my legs is actually working. To figure out what percentage that is, you use the cosine back to good old trigonometry. So cosine of 45 is going to give you about 71. And the rest of that energy is lost. So let's dig just a little bit deeper into that trigonometry so we can apply it to other angles and other concepts moving forward. Let's say I have that force vector at 45 degrees of strength, let's say 100, and that means that there's going to be a sideways component that's equal to an up and down component. If you do the math, the sine and the cosine of 45 degrees, you'll see that it's 70.7 ish. If you want to verify this, you can use good old Pythagoras. Remember, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, or sometimes in trigonometry we say h squared, the hypotenuse. And you'll see, if you do 70.7 squared plus 70.7 squared, you will get 100 squared. I promise, it's math, it's trigonometry. Okay, away with Pythagoras. Let's take a look at this triangle. That up and down component is that forward and back component we talked about already. This is how the wheels move naturally on the floor. It contributes nothing to your speed or power. It's only that adjacent component that contributes. That's how we got that 71%. And that's why if you push backwards at a 45 degree angle, only 71% of your power actually has any potential to drive you forward in space. So losing 30% of your power isn't great, but it can get even worse very quickly. So if you're pushing at a 60 degree angle, which isn't that different than a 45 degree angle, especially when you're going quickly around the track and roller derby's happening. So if you're pushing at a 60 degree angle, you're actually only getting 50% of your power. And you can imagine the more that angle is, the less power you're getting to propel yourself forward. So that is a very sad situation. Of course, what we want, you've already guessed, we want to push straight to the side. We want to get 100% of our power every time we push, and we're going to be pushing through all four wheels into the ground, straight to the side. Now, as we push all four wheels into the ground, straight to the side, that's going to put my foot in a little bit of a funny position as I get far away from my body. That's totally fine. Just feel it out. You want to keep all four wheels on the ground as long as you can, pushing as much weight as you can into it, and then bring it back in. You will see, once you start doing that, if you haven't been, you're going to go way faster than you ever did before. Okay, with all that math, let's get to a way to practice this and put it into use. So take a nice derby stance. Let's work with our outside leg first. I'm going to push all four wheels into the ground and push straight to the side. On one leg, push straight to the side, bring it in, straight to the side. It also can help to balance with your foot flexed. That way you can really check that you're using all four wheels and you're not getting into that toe flick situation at a 45 degree angle. So you push through all four wheels in a flexed foot position, hold it for a second, and bring it in. We have two legs, and we really want to make sure we're using both of them. So we need to use the inside leg too. You can practice this in your skates. I like to do sort of a sticky skate pattern. I go out wide with both my legs on the ground, feet on the ground, and then I take my inside leg and pull it straight through. Again, hold it for a second. Put it back up, pull it, and then you can do a sticky skate, or if you're ready and you can balance on your outside leg, you can lift it up, put it in. And it's really easy with the inside leg to really get into those bad angles, like 60 degrees or worse, where you're losing all of your power. So once you have both of your legs working pretty well individually, let's look at the choreography to a frontwards crossover that makes this all work. And spoiler alert, your backwards crossover is essentially the same thing. So with your outside foot, you're gonna push straight to the side. It's gonna cross over at the same time as your inside leg pulls, just as we practiced. Once I'm in this position, it's gonna reverse. So my outside leg is gonna push straight to the side, all four wheels, at the same time as my inside leg comes and replaces to the inside. And then I repeat, my inside leg pulls at the same time as my outside leg crosses over. And then the outside leg pushes, the inside leg pulls, outside leg pushes, inside leg pulls, outside leg pushes, inside leg pulls, outside leg pushes. I'm like a digging creature and I'm trying to dig a giant sand dune to the outside. So my outside leg digs, my inside leg digs, my outside leg digs, my inside leg. And that's how you want to dig into the track with your maximum power, maximum speed, like a monster, and just tear around the track. And that's exactly the feeling we want. Especially if you've only been using your outside leg or you've got some weird angles going on. Once you find this for the first time, you're going to feel almost out of control. You have so much power and so much speed. You're like, wow, I'm going so fast around the inside. It's amazing. So our outside leg is pushing, our inside leg is pulling, and you'll notice those force vectors, those force arrows are going in the same direction. So we're pushing with our outside and inside leg really in the same direction. And as you can imagine, if you push against something in this direction, in this case the ground, it's going to move our body in the opposite direction. So We're pushing straight side. Our body's going to tend to move directly side towards the inside of the track. And this is exactly what we want. Let's look at it on one of the turns. So here we have a little torpedo person in the turn of the track moving forward. Those green arrows are both outside and inside legs combined here, pushing towards the outside. This is going to generate a force towards the inside of the track. As you know from Newton, force equals mass times acceleration. So this is like an acceleration towards the inside of the track. So why is this good? Why is this what we want? Well, if we take a look at our little torpedo person, if they did nothing and didn't apply any forces into the ground, they would just roll on their wheels in a straight line right off the track. This is known as momentum, impetus, inertia. But what our torpedo person is doing is applying a force and giving itself an acceleration towards the inside of the track. And if we take that momentum off the track and the acceleration towards the center of the track, that's going to give us an addition of those two forces, which is moving straight down the track. And that is exactly what we want, is to move really fast straight down the track. FYI, you may have seen this before. It's known as centripetal acceleration, and that means center seeking. So I'm sure some of you have one more question, which is the roller derby track, it's not a circle. There are straight parts in it. Those straight parts are pretty long, so what gives? If we keep having the centripetal acceleration, we'll just go around in circles, and that's not what we want. That's true. However, if you look at the path most people take around the track, which I would call the most efficient line, if you want to dig more into lines around the track, check out the fastest line video I made, but it's kind of a circular-esque diamond-y square that we trace out with our bodies around the track to maximize our efficiency, exactly because we can continue this crossover motion as we go around the track, really get into our stride and get lots of power and lots of efficiency. Now, the most efficient line is kind of like a circle. So that's the short answer. We basically turn the oval more or less into a circle so we can keep that up. If you're practicing your stride and on the straightaways, you have a couple strides where you're not crossing over, that's fine. But I think you really want to aim to make sure you're using both feet all the time, pushing to the side through all four wheels, and you'll be fine. There's just one more topic I want to cover in this video, and that is backwards skating. Now, a backwards crossover and all this stride work is essentially the same going backwards. It just takes some practice to integrate it into your body. There's a couple differences. So let's talk about forward skating first. So when I'm in my really good derby stance, my chest is up, my head is up, my hips are low, my knees are bent and forward, and I'm doing this amazing stride work, I'm not 100% upright, right? There's a little bit of a tendency to be falling towards the center of the circle. So I'm falling a little bit into the circle and just a little bit forward. So when I go to skate backwards, there needs to be a little tendency to be falling in towards the center of the track. So I'm moving this way, this is my inside of the track, and backwards just a little bit. So what this is gonna do is bring your weight a little bit farther back in your body, and you'll be a little bit more upright. There's a very strong, I call it the butt-heel connection. So you feel the weight in your hips dropping straight down to the back of your heel, not so much the front of your feet. Otherwise, what happens is people try to skate backwards, and they're kind of lean forward and it doesn't work. You need to be a little bit more upright. You can almost overcompensate as you're learning. And think of your weights being in your heels, your back wheels, just a little bit more. I really recommend taking your inside arm, pointing it down the track. If you have a friend to grab onto it to make sure you don't start cheating and twisting the wrong way. This gives your body just a little twist towards the center of the track, which helps with this motion. So hand backwards, twist in. Otherwise, you really want to be thinking of exactly the same things. Good position, push through all four wheels, straight to the side as much as possible, and using both legs. Don't forget about your inside leg. So let's recap. There are three main things you have to do with your stride, whether you're going forward or backwards. If you're going down a straightaway, if you're going around the corner, it's all the same. You need to be using all four wheels. Weight into all four wheels as much as possible all the time. That's going to give you the maximum speed. Second, you want to be pushing and pulling straight to the side. As much as possible, use trigonometry to your advantage and get the most power you can by going straight to the side. And thirdly, use the inside leg. A lot of people overemphasize the outside leg and don't practice enough that pulling motion. It literally doubles your power. So what I recommend is practicing your inside leg more. When you're working on your stride work, really work on that inside leg and that dragging motion. And skaters that go fast, you can see them using both of their legs as they go around the track. So really get into using both legs. So those are the three main points. Practice them, get on the track, share them with other people, talk to your coaches, work on them, and your stride is going to improve, I promise. And you can say it was thanks to the power of science that your roller derby has improved. Thanks a lot for joining me. Can't wait to see you again soon for another lesson.
The science of derby, the science of derby. Let's learn something new.